First of all, thank you very much for the kind invitation to participate in this meeting. European Bifurcation Club, as you may know, was created in 2004 as a think tank of interventional cardiologists with a passion for bifurcation treatment. We had the first meeting in 2005, and since then every year we meet once a year and we try to discuss the most contemporary update in basic research, as well as clinical results of bifurcation PCI, and then share it with the community worldwide. Since 2010, our goal was to spread the discussion among the clubs worldwide and to officially communicate with all bifurcation societies. Since the very beginning, we have excellent cooperation with Japanese, Korean, Asian Bifurcation Club. And then since the last year, we also helped and supported creation of the Sky Bifurcation Club in United States, then another American Bifurcation Club in Latin America, Latin Bifurcation Club, as well as Canadian Bifurcation Club. So we like to build the bridges among interventionists and then to discuss and build together consensus in order to better treat our patients with bifurcation lesions, especially those with left main bifurcation. As you all know, I'm sure that since 2017, we have the results of DK Crash 5. And based on that strategy, there is now in the European guidelines recommendation class 2B to treat left main bifurcation with two stent strategy upfront. However, if we go from the beginning, there are many trials which show the lack of benefit associated with systematic use of two stent strategies for bifurcation. And I know that results are well known from the Nordic, BBC1, BBK, then Cactus, etc. And then also European Bifurcation Club published EBC2 study. In true bifurcations with large diameter, we compared again provisional with the culotte. And then we demonstrated that there is no really systematic benefit of two stent strategy compared to provisional strategy. Also, some publications with longer term outcome, like the publication of the individual patient data from the Nordic and BBC1 study by Dr. Behan in 2016, showed that with time, there was difference in hard clinical endpoints, including mortality. Mortality was higher with more metal with two stent strategy upfront in these two studies. So our goal was to test whether we really have different results than that in the left main. Left main is frequently described as a different bifurcation, different animal, because first of the wide angle, it's 80 degrees on the average compared to 50 to 60 degrees for all other bifurcations outside the left main. Then both branches are main vessels. There is no really clear side branch, since circumflex in 95% of cases supplies more than 10% of myocardial mass of the left ventricle and becomes very important branch as much as the other one. Area of the left main is prone to calcification deposition. Ostium is frequently involved, and in ostium we have more fibrosis. And of course, because of that, there is a greater need for vessel preparation. So more demanding anatomically as well as procedurally. So our expectation was that two stent techniques in this scenario could be even worse compared to non-left main bifurcations. And there was some ample evidence from non-randomized trials showing the worst outcome of two stents in the left main. However, randomized data from Prof. Chen supports DK crash in left main. For that reason, in 2015, we initiated EBC main study, European Bifurcation Club left main study, a randomized comparison of single versus dual stenting for true bifurcation left main coronary lesions. And finally, this study was just recently, a month ago, presented as one of the most important late-breaking clinical trials at EuroPCR 2021 with the simultaneous publication in the European Heart Journal. Study hypothesis was that we would like to examine clinical outcomes of patients with true left main bifurcation lesions, comparing stepwise layered provisional strategy versus systematic plan dual stent strategy. Primary endpoint was overall mortality, TLR, and all myocardial infarctions at 1 year, and secondary endpoints were the components of the primary outcome plus stent thrombosis. Here is the study flow. Indications for EBC main were exactly the same as indications for DK crash 5, so stable or unstable angina pectoris with unprotected left main bifurcation through bifurcations Medina type 111 or 011, with both branches being larger than 2.75 millimeters, who required PCI. 467 patients in total, single stent versus dual stent strategy, 230 versus 235, and the primary endpoint, as I said, was the composite of death, MI, and TLR at 1 year. Study was performed in 31 European centers in 11 countries. Stent was used Medtronic Resolute Onyx, and CRO was CERC, Marie-Claude Maurice, and the group of experts from France. Stent that we used in this study was Resolute Onyx DES, XLV sizes, purposefully designed to treat the left main. We selected this design because of its broad size matrix and specifically designed with 4.5 and 5.0 diameters to be able to comfortably expand to 6 millimeters, which should be optimized for large left main bifurcations because of the sustained radial strength and preserved structural integrity at the overexpansion. A very important aspect, we learned from the DK crash 5 that we have to carefully describe the steps of both provisional as well as for systematic two-stent approach. Provisional approach was step-by-step layered strategy according to European Bifurcation Club consensus documents from 2009 to 2015. What is very important, proximal optimization technique and kissing were both mandated. In systematic two-stent approach, operator choice was the selection of the strategy. However, all the strategies of two stents, T-TAP, culotte, or DK crash, were described step by step according to European Bifurcation Club consensus documents, mandating high pressure ostial bifurcation dilatations of both limb, followed by kissing in both groups, plus minus final pot. Here is the population. Mean age was around 70 degrees, 30% diabetes. Syntax score was 23, radial approach in 3/4 of cases, and predominantly 6 French was used. Number of stents, of course, and stented length according to design were lower in the stepwise provisional, but very important secondary endpoints show that procedural duration, amount of contrast, fluoroscopy time, and radiation were all less with systematic provisional compared to two-stent strategy. Here is the procedural flow. Of course, we know that in the provisional group, we had 85% of cases with POT, 90% of cases with kissing, and importantly, 1 out of 5, 22%, required per definition second stent. So that was not bailout stenting, that was per definition continuation of the provisional for after kissing with the second stent, and then mandatory kissing in all cases. So all 51 had kissing with two stent strategy and final pot in 81%. If we speak about systematic two stent strategy, the most widely used strategy was culotte, half of the cases, and then T and TAP, another 33%, and then DK crash with 11 cases. So main vessel standing first was in all cases in stepwise provisional and in 51% in systematic dual stand strategy. I would like to point your attention to reasons for using the second stand in the stepwise provisional. So the reason for stenting was either dissection 22 cases or residual stenosis 26, and only in one case, impaired flow in the side branch following main vessel stenting. So study results were neutral. There was no difference. There was some numerically smaller increase rate in the two-stent strategy of target lesion revascularization, although not reaching statistical significance, but there is 6.1% versus 9.3% at 1 year. And if we compare EBC main with DK crash 5, we can say that in two studies, we had similar number of patients. We had publications 2021 versus 2016. All the sites in EBC main were European, 26 sites in Asia, and one site of IMAD Shaban in Europe for DK crash 5. Syntax score was higher in DK crash 5, as well as side branch lesion length 16 versus 7 millimeters. And we had difference also in the rate of two-stent strategy in provisional arm, 22% in EBC main versus 45% in DK crash 5. Planned two-stent strategy in Europe was predominantly culotte and tap. In DK crash 5, of course, DK crash. Use of imaging was low in both studies, 40% versus 41%. And primary endpoint was much broader in EBC main. So we had overall mortality, all MIs and TLR in DK crash 5, cardiac mortality, target vessel MI and TLR. And of course, difference in results, neutral results of EBC main versus positive results in DK crash 5. So I would like to conclude that according to EBC main study, stent treatment of true bifurcations has generally good clinical outcomes with both one versus two stent strategy. Patients are treated equally well with stepwise layered provisional as with more complex two stent approach. But in a stepwise strategy, we don't need to prejudge the issue whether we need one or two stents. We just follow the strategy and we add second stent only when it's necessary. And this was in one out of five cases. There was numerically fewer serious adverse events with stepwise provisional. Only 1/5 of patients in provisional group really required second stent. So in our interpretation, stepwise provisional should remain the approach of choice for majority of left main bifurcation interventions. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you next year in Indonesia.